Hi guys, welcome to Cognitive Hub Tableau tutorials. In the previous lecture, we have seen about the different levels of aggregated measures and how to do the aggregation and granularity and all. Now in this video, I am going little bit deeper into the Tableau, like how to create an area chart with this data set that we have seen in the previous lecture. So now without wasting any time, let's dive into the topic. Okay guys, here as we discussed in the previous lecture, we have created this, like we took the data set from the Google, and what this data set will contain is that specimen collection date and age group and new confirmed cases, cumulative confirmed cases. And here specimen collection date, age group and last updated date are the dimensions, and new confirmed cases and cumulative confirmed cases are nothing but measures here. So I already explained about the data sets clearly in my previous lectures in the time series or in the aggregation videos. If you don't have any knowledge about the data set and how we worked on the splitting of the data sets like date, month, quarter, year and all, you can go to my previous lectures and have a look on it with the data sets, because I am using the same data set for the last four videos. Okay, now what I am doing is here I took the day specimen collection date and filtered it out with the day as a measure, and then row I am taking the new confirmed cases, and I am using the aggregation measure sum here. So what I am doing is, the first thing, I am just coloring it out with the age group as color. So we are having a lot of things here, and also I am giving the age group as shape as well. So this is the group, this is the thing that we are getting. So these are the things that you will be having. There are a lot more graphs, like we will be having on the left and right as well. So for now, let us concentrate on this. So why we will be using this area chart is, suppose here if you observe this is a lot of clumsy data. Like even though if you are trying to plot it on the single particular shape, you are not able to point out to the single one, and it is very difficult to identify, because if you consider the area between the March 1 and April 1, there are a lot of things which are already clumsy. Similarly, if you have a look on this May 1 and June 1, there are a lot of things which are already overlapped with each other, so we are not able to identify the exact one. So for that, we will be looking for the other reasonable graph. Suppose if you look on this particular graph, it is just a data, the data representation. Suppose if you consider this, in the 7th March, it is showing the total confirmed cases are 3, and all those 3 are in 18 to 30 age group itself. And there are no cases for 8th, 9th and 10th, but there are confirmed cases in 15th March, and it is showing the aggregated values for that particular age group. So this is how it is showing, but this is also one of the this is also, by just having a look on it, we can't able to identify. But as a Tableau developer, you need to identify which is the best visualization to represent the given data. And if you observe this heat maps, it is also one of the not able to identify clearly. And if you observe the highlight tables, it is little bit okay, but it is also not suggested to use every time. And pie chart is not the suitable ones. Bar chart, it will show like this, and we can also show for every date we can show the area graphs here, like the lines where we will be having the positive cases and the negative cases with respect to the area. And you can see the bar graphs here, the maximum and minimum. And you can also use the tree maps. Again, it is very difficult to understand what is the things that we need to identify here. And if you use the bubbles, it is also a little bit difficult. So this is the one that we are using, the plots with respect to the dates. And again, this is the one, I think this is got completely separated now. Yeah, so if you click on this area, again the bubbles is also not a suitable one, because by looking this, you can able to identify, but it is very difficult to identify which one is which. You can see the pink ones are the one which are having under 18 have registered the new corona cases very less. But in the case of age group 18 to 30, there are a lot of COVID-19 cases. So by looking this, you can give the high level picture, but not the detailed picture. So we are having the area charts here. So click on this area charts. So this is how you will be having. Let me label it again. So let me increase this. If you give this, then it will be very nice. Suppose if you have the data set very less, then it is very useful. Here what we are having is we are having very less data set, and so this is how you will you need to identify. Suppose if you want only the age groups with respect to 41 to 50, then you can click on that particular a color, and then only that one will get highlighted. Similarly for 51 to 60, this is the graph. So you can observe this is the maximum one, and this is the peak value where you will be having the most number of COVID-19 cases. So this age group is 18 to 30, and second one was 31 to 40, and then 41 to 50, and then 51 to 60. And then you can also label it also with the COVID-19 cases. Just I am dragging it to label. So if you observe this, because it is completely overlapped, so if you want to see it and just took a very little amount of data and just drag and drop, like maximize this. So okay, let me do it for month. Yeah, this is better one. So if you consider the months, and okay, so let me delete this COVID-19 cases. Age group, I am giving it in the label. So if you observe this, so new confirmed cases will be represented on the left side, and the month is represented on the bottom, and the COVID-19 case, like the age group, is represented on the table itself. So if you observe this, what it is saying, the under 19 groups are started from the COVID-19 registered case for under 19 group is started from April, and it the range is also very less. Very few people who are having age under 18 are less affected, and again the most affected was 18 to 30 region group, and 31 to 40 are little bit affected groups, and like that it will show the exact details. So this is how you will use the area charts, and if you want to see only the details about the area charts, like only the maximum ones, then you can click on the 18 to 30 groups, and rest of the things will go transparent, like will be there, but just it won't get highlighted. Only the one with what you want to select, it will get highlighted. Similarly, if you want only 31 to 40, then you can click on this and it will get highlighted. So like this. So if you click on that and if you drag and drop the to that particular graph, then you will be having some tooltip as well here with the age group and monthly specimen dates as well as new confirmed cases. So whatever the filters that you have mentioned here, you will be having all those information on that particular tooltip. So this is how you will use the area charts. So simply we can see it as area charts will be used whenever you have a large amount of density and you want to show the information in a single stretch, then you will be using this area charts. So this is all about this video, guys. Thank you for watching.